Smoked haddock and spinach baked eggs.
Smoked haddock, one of my favourite fish. Delicious, highly sustainable, packed with protein, lightly smoked. And it's not a dye smoke, there's a big difference. So you haven't got that bright yellow tinge. So much better.
Next, baby spinach.
It's a spinach that's very young, full of zinc, great flavour. Little teaspoon of olive oil, knob of butter. That little touch of oil stops the butter from burning. It looks like a lot of spinach, but it's gonna disintegrate almost by two-thirds. When I'm cooking spinach in butter, I open up the top of my pepper mill so the pepper becomes almost like sort of cracked pepper, not so fine.
Once your spinach has reduced down by two-thirds, add in your cubes of smoked haddock.
Tarragon. It's got that nice vinegary flavour, quite tart. Pick off the little buds from the stalks. Keep hold of these. I'm grateful when you're making a tarragon vinegar. Red wine vinegar, tarragon stalks in. Chop your tarragon into your creme fraiche. Little season. Now, grain mustard goes brilliantly well with haddock. Incredible.
This mustardy, herby creme fraiche will work equally well partnered with grilled chicken.
The haddock's starting to flake because it's smoked, lightly cured. It cooks so quickly. Your creme fraiche. Nice. Now, it's almost like the beginning of the perfect fish pie. But as opposed to putting pastry on top, the eggs are going to bake on top, so you've got this wonderful egg crust. Turn the gas off. Now, crack your eggs around the outside. Just a little twist of pepper. Get the remainder of your creme fraiche and put a little dollop in between. That adds richness to the egg whites. Into the oven at 180 for 10 to 12 minutes.
Whilst the haddock and eggs bake together, I can knock up a simple spring onion garnish.
And professional kitchen chefs refuse to use the top of the spring onions, but I love that nice dark green flavour. It's less harsh than the white. The smell of baked mustard, you can't beat. That is beautiful. Spinach has almost melted in with the haddock. Now just sprinkle your spring onions. That gives it that really nice sharpness. Wow.
My ultimate hearty breakfast, smoked haddock and spinach baked eggs. So packed with protein and iron, you'll be raring to dive into the day ahead.
There's something quite nostalgic about a boiled egg. It's something that's never lost its magic when you slice that top off and dunk that soldier into the yolk.
You can't mess with a deliciously runny yolk, but this is what I like to dunk in it.
An anchovy soldier. Anchovies, into pestle mortar. No salt, naturally. Yeah, anchovies are very salty, so just a touch of pepper.
Rich in omega-3s, the amazing tinned anchovy is a natural flavour enhancer, and I use it to pepper many a savoury dish, from roast lamb to the humble toasted soldier.
Grind them to a really nice, smooth paste. The smell of that is almost like being at the seaside. Now, get your soft butter. And just put half the butter in first. 50-50 is the way, 50% anchovy, 50% butter. That way you've got that real nice salty creaminess. Mix that up. That's absolutely delicious. Trust me, finishing that anchovy butter on a slice of grilled fish, I'm in heaven. The bread. This is a sourdough. Delicious, very crusty. Take four nice slices. Now, get that pan nice and hot. A couple of tablespoons of that anchovy oil into the pan, and then get your bread and lightly fry each side. The smell of that anchovy oil is incredible. Take that out. Now, bring your water up to the boil. The secret of softly boiling an egg is to place them into the water gently, on a spoon, in, and just tilt so they don't hit the bottom. Nice and light. Up to the boil, count to five, turn the gas down. Is it 4.5 minutes? Is it 5 minutes for a soft boiled egg? I've cooked thousands of them, and every time it's 4.5 minutes. Whilst that's boiling, get your bread and spread that on there. That is incredible. Chopped parsley brings that kind of freshness. Goes brilliantly well with the anchovies. Hear that crunch on. And cyber, I can't resist. Oh, my God. Right. Gas off. One. Beauty in. Two. I feel like a five-year-old again. This is that moment when you open the vault and that little magic inside is all yours. Mm. It's a great twist on a great classic. Wow.
Perfectly soft-boiled eggs with dressed-up anchovy butter soldiers.
Who would have thought that egg and soldiers could be that delicious? Mm. Some of the best food I had in India was street food. And every little food stall was cooking up something spicy, something delicious. A little teaspoon of oil. I'm gonna toast off a teaspoon of cumin. Mustard seeds, a touch of salt and pepper. Lightly fry them off. It's really important to cook off the spices. It intensifies the flavor, but really draws out that nice, spicy, deep, rich flavor. So, onion, three fingers, one in front, two behind, nice and fine. Onions in. Now, we're gonna caramelize those onions. Mustard seeds have started to infuse. Cumin has that nice kick. Now, we'll put a little touch of butter in there. Get it nice and sort of rich. Gas up nice and high, and really caramelize those onions now.
Once the onions have turned a rich golden color,
that's what I'm looking for. That is beautiful.
Add baby spinach.
Keep that pan nice and hot. If you don't cook it out, the actual breakfast ends up watery.
When the spinach is cooked, set aside, and it's onto the spicy eggs.
Now the breakfast really starts to come alight. Four nice eggs. Now give those eggs a little whisk, a little touch of butter into the pan, a little teaspoon of oil so the butter doesn't burn.
When the butter and oil are hot, add a teaspoon of garam masala and turmeric.
Cook that out. Now, take your eggs into the pan. Almost gonna make like a really nice spicy scrambled egg. Turn the gas down. Now, as the scrambled egg comes together, just finish that with a little bit of butter. I quite like the sort of creaminess. Makes it so much more delicious. And then from there, I'm gonna get my spinach. Chop up. And then fold in the spinach to your scrambled egg. Something quite exciting about eating spice for breakfast, but it's served in these wonderful little thin naan breads.
This will work with any flatbread or wrap you fancy.
And then lightly toast your naan.
Take the eggs off the heat whilst you get on with the last job, a quick mint and spice yogurt dressing.
A couple of tablespoons of fresh yogurt in. There's always something to take out the heat.
Then add chopped mint, salt, and turmeric.
Mix that in. Now, take a scrambled egg and half fill the naan. God, it smells incredible. Get your yogurt. Cool that down on top and lift that over. And for me, that's what really stands out with street food in India. How delicious they can make street food with a little bit of spice. Amazing.
Once you try this spicy wrap, I promise you, scrambled eggs will never taste the same. Party. Spicy Mexican eggs.
This is a very classic Mexican-style brunch dish. Bold, kick-ass flavors. Slice of chili, seeds in. Garlic sliced, nice and thinly. Tablespoon of olive oil. I'm a big fan of brunches. And if you get it right, a great brunch can see you right through to dinner. Now, to start the sort of spicy, fragrant tomato sauce, get your cumin in there. Garlic, chili, roasted cumin, red onions. Already sounds Mexican. Once that starts getting really nice and crispy, in with your tomatoes. Never embarrassed using good canned tomatoes. I do it all the time, cooking at home. Now, by reducing that, you sort of come down to a delicious paste. Leave that to simmer.
Next, canned beans called black beans. These are authentically Mexican, but canalini beans or chickpeas will work just fine.
Just rinse them in a little bit of water. That is beautiful. Turn off the gas and just let it absorb.
Leaving the dense beans to luxuriate in the spicy tomato sauce will allow them to soften and soak up all the flavor. Next, oil and season an oven-proof dish for my spicy egg brunch to bake in.
And just get some of that oil round the outside. Take your corn tortillas, slice them in half, and then just stick them to the side. These are a staple in Mexico. Take one and place that in the center. Get your mix and place that on top of the tortilla. Spread that out nice and smoothly. Lift up those little flaps. I want that crisp shell on the outside. Now, your eggs and cheese. Get the base of the egg and just make a little hole in there and then crack the egg into there. Again, use a little point. Put your egg in there. One, two, three, four, five, and one in the middle. Gently crack and get the egg to sit inside, almost like it's a little dugout. And then one for the center. Get a really nice, rich, delicious, strong Montgomery cheddar. I want to grate the tortilla shell as well, so get generous with it on the top. I'm going to season that with these little babies, little chili flakes. They're my little secret weapon, and they're going to spice up that egg. A touch of salt, a touch of pepper. Sit that in the oven to bake for 8 to 10 minutes at 180. That smells incredible. Just a little bit of coriander to finish it off. And that, for me, is what brunch is all about. Let's go.
A fantastic fiery brunch to get your party started. Spicy Mexican eggs in a crispy tortilla shell.